Okay, George Rotito just did a video about me and Da Vinci and some other people, and he called me a detractor, and he said that I like to say negative things about him. But what happened was, I wrote something on his channel. It was, let's see, quote. It was to somebody else. Well, he must be a genius because the most I've seen on YouTube is about $220. Now, that wasn't meant to be a criticism. I was just commenting on the fact that he's really good at making money off of YouTube. Well, he took this as some sort of attack, and he misinterpreted it, and he completely overreacted to it. So he puts out this video attacking me, saying that I'm jealous of him and how he's making all this money, and how he gets $1,200 checks, $1,600 checks, and he makes a living off of YouTube. And what happened was, he overreacted, and in this video he did something very, very interesting, and I want you guys to check this video out. He tried to tell me that I should censor you guys and protect him or anybody else that I supposedly like on YouTube. I'm not making this up. After all this time that I said that I don't delete comments, I don't block users, he tried to tell me what to do on my channel. And you really gotta check out the tone. The tone in the video in which he tries to tell me what to do. Somebody reposted it, by the way, because he hurry up and took it down because he got a lot of negative comments because of it. Anyway, it's very different from the tone in which he does his latest video in, when he talks about his detractors, you know. And then there was another comment where he said, Demcast, stop playing both sides of the fence. You know you have a problem with me taking sponsors. Quit trying to pretend to be nice. You're full of bullshit. Yeah, okay, that's really positive vibes there. First of all, I don't have problems with sponsors. I don't have problems with anybody taking sponsors. I've said this over and over and over and over again. I don't know how many times I can say this. Okay, I haven't spoken out about any particular sponsor, even though I don't like some of the sponsors that some people have. I just kept my mouth shut about it, okay? And I'm not interested in joining any sponsors, okay? The thing about George Rotito and his Inflation.us is that people are accusing him, they're accusing the organization and John Libet, who is a big part of the organization, of using their newsletter and their website to pump and dump stocks. Basically, the idea is that you buy a worthless penny stock. You put a whole bunch of information out there to try to encourage people to buy into the stock. People buy into the stock, and as it goes up, you sell, and then it just drops right back down. That's called a pump and dump scheme. That's what George Rotito and Inflation.us is basically being accused of. I don't know enough about the organization to really have a comment on it, but there was an interview where John Libet was interviewed by by this guy, Cody. Okay, the interview takes place on Fox or Fox Business, and the reporter essentially confronts John Libet on some of his business practices. Now, essentially, the guy asks him if he accepts $40,000, or does he accept money to promote certain types of stock. And his response is very, very interesting. Again, check the video out yourself. Okay, who is John Libet? Some people say that he's a sock-picking genius. Maybe he is, maybe he isn't. I don't know. I'm just looking at something right here on New York Times Magazine. It's a statement from Paul R. Carey, a commissioner of the Securities and Exchange Commission. This was published in March 25th, 2001. I'll put a link in the description box for this. Basically, they said that at the age of 15, Libet was involved in illegal activity, basically pumping and dumping stocks, falsely recommending stocks. It says, quote, Libet, through his fraudulent conduct, ensured that he was among the winners who bought at low prices and sold at inflated high prices. Many others who purchased at the height of the manipulation lost money when the stock price collapsed. So this is basically what this is pretty much part of his past, and I don't know if he's still doing stuff like that. I just know that this is what he's being accused of. So again, it's up to you guys to determine whether this is true or not. Now, just because Libet has a history when he was a kid doesn't mean that he's necessarily doing something illegal now. That's also important to point out. And it's also important to point out that even though Backburner News is associated with Libid, and I believe Vision Victory is associated with Inflation.us, these guys have been pretty decent to me. They haven't been mean or anything. They haven't been aggressive. They haven't insulted me or anything like that. And Backburner News did do a video response to some of these controversies. So I'm going to put a link in my description box for that so you guys have access to that. And again, I just want you guys to just look at the information and judge for yourself. I want you guys to check out George Rotito's video response. Not just the latest one, but the one where he tries to tell me what I should do with my channel. And really, if you're not interested, I understand, because I'm not really interested in talking about this guy. I'm interested in talking about the economy. I'm interested in talking about food, preparing, stockpiling food, stockpiling water, getting a gun to protect your family, getting ammunition. These are the things I'm really interested in. But just to set the record straight, to make you guys realize that there's two sides to the story, and I'm not just out to get this guy. You know, I'll let you guys decide for yourself, but I just want to let you guys know what's really going on here, and I don't want you guys to get the impression that, you know, I'm just attacking away at the guy. The guy sent me a private message saying that I was a self-righteous prick, you know. Among other things, I was like, okay. And now he's doing this video acting like Mr. Cool, so watch it yourself. Anyway, have a good day. Bye.